We have like the special guest ever in the house. It's Thema Friday. Make some noise, Thema Williams.
Thema's in the building, guys.
Boss a split.
Morning, Thema.
That's a little too much, really.
Why should she bust a split? Get, Rudy got off the floor.
Why would she bust a split? We feel it's not that type of show, bro.
Morning, Thema. Welcome.
Thank you.
How are you?
I'm good.
I know we're a little hype, eh? And you calm as ever. And, you know, you must be wake up yet, but we've been up and we had coffee.
Them had coffee.
Okay, but normally, the trading schedule is in the early morning.
No, I used to do mornings, but I recently changed to just afternoons.
Okay. Yeah, oh, so like this is really early for you now.
Well, I told you to be accustomed to getting up at 4 and being all hype, and I told you to come in doing some cartwheels.
I'm
a little disappointed,
yeah.
I was expecting cartwheels down the corridor.
Yeah, two split coming down the nothing.
I'm real disappointed. It's only so often in the presence of greatness, and I was expecting to put on my gram. We had a flipping morning this morning, but it just didn't happen.
No. So how are you, my love?
I'm good so far.
Good. That's the first time Trinidad really getting a feel of you. I mean, they've seen you in a very official interview. Rudy, stop it. This is a professional,
All right, trying to rinse out
your ears this Sunday morning, man. Douglas made smoothie for him, eh? I just want you to know.
You can make smoothie?
No.
Ah, thank you.
See what I'm talking about?
So how tired are you? Like, emotionally?
Now you realize, Thema, arms bigger than your whole frame. I just want to put that out there.
Thanks, Jaiga.
Wait. Let me ask you, Thema. What do you eat for breakfast on the morning? Like, as an athlete, what do you eat?
I usually just eat cereal.
Cereal alone?
All these years, I tried all these years. And the cereal is the key.
All right.
Come on.
So, you have a snack after, before lunch? Give us like an average day of what you eat.
Okay, so I wake up, I eat like cereal and a banana. And then for lunch, I would have whatever they cook, like probably like rice and like maybe like some beans.
Chicken.
A little piece of chicken.
Mm-hmm. A little piece? Why can't be a big piece?
A little piece of chicken. And then for dinner, I would have the same thing again.
So like big portions?
Nah, not for dinner. The portions for dinner will be a little bit smaller. Oh,
okay. But your big portion is lunch.
Yeah, because I practice after lunch.
All right. So what kind of snack you eat in the day too? Snacks. You do it. I realize you ain't call no doubles. No. Okay.
Not really
no. All right. what is it like your snacks?
I like fruits and like nuts and stuff for snacks mostly.
All right, we're trying to help Rudy. Like, because we have Ding Dong, there's a challenge for Ding Dong to lose 50 pounds.
Ding Dong drop 50.
And then there's also a challenge we're starting for him
to gain 50. Gain 50.
So the nuts, right? Is it cashew nuts?
Cashew nuts, almonds.
What the honey roasted
pistachios.
One? The honey roasted one, good
I
work.
Don't really go. No,
let me what we should ask though is, since you've been home,
right?
For it's been how long now? A week and a half, 2 weeks?
A week and 3 days.
Yeah.
All right. Since you've been home, have you cheated food wise?
Oh yeah. I mean, I had some doubles and stuff.
Duh.
You must eat granny food and things.
Yeah. Granny real cooking for me. So I have to eat it.
Yeah, but in all fairness though, Nikki, this is somebody who's been on a mission from since when? 3, 4.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess.
Well, she said she knew she wanted to be in the Olympics from what? 8?
8 years old.
8.
Mm-hmm. I started at 6 though.
Well, it's a habit. It's a lifestyle for her. So asking her what she eats in the morning, that kind of thing. Like, we'll be here and go. So ladies out there, I understand you've seen the photograph. You see Thema, your China said, you can't look like Thema by Monday. So don't wake up tomorrow, have cereal. Then Sunday have cereal. And Monday morning, you look in the mirror and say, I wonder if I look like Thema. No, you're not looking like Thema.
All right.
Only telling people the wrong thing. It's at 2 years home now. 2 years going to work now. Say, wait, nice. Only cereal and banana.
Rice, beans, and chicken.
The running my quick shop now to buy cereal, get banana. Then it's peas and chicken today. And then Monday, they're looking in front of me to take a selfie. It's not going to work like that, honey. This is something that's been happening over a period of, 15 years?
Yes. So, Thema, you said at 8, you knew you wanted to be at the Olympics. You remember that far back, of course, and tell us how you knew that's where I want to be when I grow up.
I saw it on like TV once, and I was like, wow.
Can you remember who you looked at? Can you remember anybody?
I was probably looking at like Dominique Dawes, probably, I was like, wow, this is incredible. It's like, I want to go to the Olympics. And my mother said, I looked at her, I was like, I want to be out there. I want to go to the Olympics. And she just looked at me and said, okay.
Okay. That's Helen, just as cool as you.
Is that okay?
Okay.
She ain't asking who you looked at, and she said Dominion. I don't know who she's talking about.
Yeah.
I'm a big nut. Yeah.
Well, she was one of the first black gymnasts in the U.S. that really kind of put the black gymnast on the
map. I only know Gabby. Sorry.
Gabby. Well, she's the second.
I know Thema and Gabby. That's it. Ask anybody.
You know what I mean? I know Thema. I know Gabby, though. I really know about Thema.
What are we doing, boy?
Well, Dominique.
I grew up in this thing, boy.
Yeah, you grew up in it, and all I know is Thema.
Dominique kind of made the way for Gabby, and Gabby kind of inspired so many other young black gymnasts.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Black gymnasts are already taking control now.
No, they.
Simone Biles, Gabby Douglas, definitely. Everybody's taking control.
And they're realizing, too, the kind of strength, too, in. Well, they always say that once the black athletes take over a sport, they take over a sport. It's not a racist statement, but it's something that they say. It's almost like, you know, they assume that black athletes are built differently. Is it that?
I think in gymnastics, it's all about power. And we have that.
Mm-hmm. You got the power.
We definitely have power.
All right, so talk us through, everyone knows the story, and is there still hope? How do you feel? You know, we hear the lawyer side of it. We heard Brian Lewis, the head of the Olympic side of it. We heard so many experts talk, but how does Thema feel in terms of the hope? Because I have a lot of hope still that you could make it to the Olympics and represent Trinidad and Tobago. How does Thema Williams feel about this?
I think with the team I'm working with, I think definitely I feel hopeful that the dream could still come true.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully that our plan of action works as we intended to.
Right. So what happens if we don't make it? Is there a hope for us to see Thema in 4 years? Is this still a dream that can be attained? Because we know that it's such a you're almost in retirement age now. You and Granny could hang in terms of gymnastics and how long the lifespan is.
Mm-hmm. Well, realistically, gymnastics these days, it doesn't even have a lifespan anymore.
No?
Mm-hmm. No.
So it's going past.
You've seen a lot of older gymnasts, like 25-year-olds. Mm-hmm. I know Lily's a kid and she's still winning.
Wow.
So
even if the doors are closed permanently, you're still going to go for 2020.
I don't know. I'll have to think about that, but I'm definitely not going to stop gymnastics.
Let's talk about the other side of Thema. Your artist.
You're a bad artist.
You have to put up some of your work on the Facebook and all our sites to show people that other side of you. Talk to me about that side, because, you know, you think that you're such a focused athlete that you don't have time for anything else.
Right. I think that's my release. Like, when I first went to Michigan, I didn't have any friends. Like, I would go home, I would look forward to drawing and stuff. So when I first went, that was when I was doing most of my work. But it mostly started in St. Joseph's Convent. Like, I would come home and, like, show my dad all my drawings, whatever. And he would be like, you know, this looks kind of good. Mm-hmm. And I was like, really? And then I just started practicing, and I kept going, and I got a lot better.
Because you have a particular style of art. It's like doodling. I don't want to call it, because probably that's not the term for it. But, you know, when you doodle and explain it to us.
They know coloring
like
book thing.
An intricate form of, like, swirls and... I always do black and white. I enjoy contrast. I always base my art mostly on like African things and like cultural origins.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, it's mostly just like kind of doodling.
And you use your body too as art.
Yes. Yeah.
Explain to us about that.
The female body. I'm really obsessed with the female body and how it moves. I think it's art. That's probably a part of the reason why I am a gymnast.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoy
body,
movement.
Bro. The female body, bro.
The female. That's flicky.
This is not something yet, man.
No. That's a stretch.
Chunks.
So you're obsessed with the female body and really showcasing it and basically all the aspects of what you do. Your art, your body as art, and also your
That's pretty much what placed her in the center of control. Mm-hmm.
Correct.
Right? Her body and her body art.
Let me talk about the picture now, because that picture got me a real vexed reaction to the picture. Explain to us your process about putting up this infamous picture.
It wasn't really a process. Like, it wasn't a big deal to me.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I was just like, I have an idea for a picture, and I'm going to do it. And I did. I remember I woke up and I was like, I'm so excited to do this picture. Because I had seen this other person do this type of picture. I was like, all right, I like this idea. I'm going to do it. And I just, I did what I did, and I don't think it's wrong to this day. Yeah. It was about bodily pride. It was about proud of being an African woman, and it was nothing more than that.
All right, with that being said, and we don't want to touch too much into the legal aspects of things. I just want to stray a little bit with something a little calm and casual, something I'm sure people are thinking about. Since the Thema, Team Thema, the hashtags and all of this, how's been the snaps and the DMs? Watch your face, watch your face, watch your face.
Yeah.
How been the snaps and the DMs?
Yeah.
Let me be real.
They go down in the DM.
Because we know it just go down in the DM.
Yeah, I mean.
Watch your face.
She's got a real blush in boy. There's a camera. Real blush in boy.
Thema, let us know. This is not your daddy talking here. Forget Auntie Nikki at this side. Forget Godmommy Nikki. This Jaiga and Rodi accent. How is the DM?
I mean, the DMs are packed.
The DM on fleek.
It's on fleek. All right, we I know the public really wants to talk to you, and we wanted this interview to be really nice and light and not attacking and too heavy, because I know your brain has been really tied up for the last while.
Let me ask an important question, Nikki. Hold on. But since the whole thing's been going on, how has been your regimen, though? I know, because I know you're kind of, as you said, the hope is there, your team is working. And when you say a team is working, we know the legal side of it, and I guess your support from your family and the immediate family, like your mom, your dad, Nikki, and these things. But putting that aside, how have you been in terms of, do you still get up, train as hard? Or has that kind of lessened down because you're a little too... Because I know it could take a toll on an
mentally,
individual. Mentally,
yeah. It's kind of hard now mentally. I go to the gym at the stadium, the elite gym, and I train with Orlando Griffith. Just trying to stay in shape right now. I think it's, I think about it at the gym sometimes. You could tell I'm a little bit down, or, and he always comes and he asks me, are you okay today, this and that, you know. It's a little bit harder, but, I mean, I still get through it.
All right, cool.
So, we want to take some calls. We
take a few ones. Just call up. Give us some love. Send some love.
Yeah. Neighbor says, Thema, keep the faith and persevere. We need more strong youths like yourself. What message would you tell young athletes, young people that have looked up to you? Because I've been getting texts, a lot of people telling me they're 5-6 year olds have been watching your videos, and mommy, I want to do that. Mommy, I want to do that. So you have inspired a whole generation of kids that want to be gymnasts, and so many young people saw the seeing your struggle right now. And what would you say to these youths listening this morning, Thema?
As simple as dream as big as you want. You could achieve anything with hard work. And even during struggles, keep fighting.
All right. Pete wants to know, who has the last say in if you go to Rio or not? No, it's at the...
I go?
It's at the International Olympic Committee level. That's where it is legally
Federation
right now.
Federation of International Gymnastics would have the final say.
Right.
I believe.
So, Pete, it's in legal hands, but yeah, they do have the final say. All right. So, Thema, you're single?
Who is that? Hey, she's
focused. No, okay,
she's
Randy.
She's taken. Randy, she's taken.
But like the, so...
Where do you come from, brother?
What do you mean? You see who you are?
Wetty, I know Wetty, you're trying to drive around Thema, but she has a driver already, okay?
We love you, Thema. Yeah, I love you.
Where do you come from?
I have a whole compilation of videos that I just go home and see and I watch it. She's flipping and skipping.
What?
And yeah.
No, you're not supposed to watch your videos like that. Back to back like that with lust in the eyes.
Them judges and them, I find you should get 10 all the time, eh? That's just me personally. Every time you judges pop some, I find you should get 10. 10. Yeah.
Thank you, Wetty.
Hey, where do you come from, boy? Oh, God.
All right, yeah, what? See, my song with us for a bit. Let's just do the GPS real quick.
Yeah. Let me just ask you one quick question. Patty wants to know what inspired you to be a gymnast.
My sister used to do gymnastics, and she would come home and she would coach me. So she was kind of my first coach. And then my mom would come home, and I would always show her skills on the bed.
Yeah, that's the first place you start, right? The bed.
Yeah. And then she was like, okay. And then she took me to the gym, and she was like, take her.
So Rusha, as I always tell people, Rusha is just as talented as you.
Yes, she is.
And this is your older sister. And where is she now? She is in a circus.
She's touring the U.S. as a circus.
And flipping all over the place.
Correct. Mm.
Yeah, she's having so much fun. Dream as big as you want, and you rock. And congratulations from all, no matter the outcome. Your foreign fans respect you. That's Trisha from the UK.
Thank you.
All right, let's do this real quick, guys.